think I'm going to do a component. So go with directory. Let's just call this users. Why not? Then we'll go, just go users component dot ts. I'm not going to add this to Git because we'll probably throw it away. Go users, like so. Import component from was that actually picking that up? I thought I saw WebStorm trying to like tell me stuff. Oh, it's a JavaScript developer. That is amazing. Yes.
There's a quick question about breaking out a component. If you're to break out a component and create another component, do you put it in the same directory or would you create another directory for a subcomponent?
So generally, I will break it out into a subdirectory. I think for the sake of just speed, a lot of times I'll leave it in the same directory and then I can go back and refactor it. And so I work through the process of refactoring through promotion, and you may have heard me talk about this at the previous Frontend Masters workshop that I did, but there's not a problem with starting very local to the problem that you're starting trying to solve. So if I want to test an idea or quickly verify something, I really want that feedback loop. And so again, the question is, what's the fastest possible way I can get something working so that I can verify that this idea is where I want to go? And if I've already established kind of that pattern, I may just jump a few steps, but there is nothing wrong, for instance, of when you're building out a component, stubbing out your sample data right in the component. And you say, I don't know like what this thing is gonna look like, so I'm just gonna create a JSON object or array and putting it in there. And then from there, you verify like, okay, now I've got the layout, I'm going to extract this out into a service. And then, you know, the question is this service ever going to live outside of this component? If yes, then you can extract it out and promote it to a common directory. And then if it's like, well, this needs to be used across multiple projects, then you break it out into a repo. So I will oftentimes start as close to the problem I'm trying to solve, even to where I'll put things in the same file initially. But then I might put it in a folder, and then once it's verified and I want somebody to look at it, then I would eventually want that to go in a separate directory. And so the idea is when somebody looks at your file structure, they have a good sense of what the module hierarchy is and the relationship that your components have one to another. A good example of this is users, or rather experiments, is that I was building out this experiments list and I realized, hey, I'm using this experiment details thing a lot. I'm going to extract that out into a component, and so now it's here. But let's say I wanted to search the experiments. Then I would probably create like an experiments search component, and that would also live in here, the experiments folder. It wouldn't have to go any higher because it's specific to that feature. But when somebody looks at this, they can very quickly tell the hierarchy. There is some level of, I think, personal preference on this, and to that, depending, so basically I adopt what's called like the pants rule, is if you're gonna wear pants in your house, then I'm gonna wear pants in my house, or when I'm at your house, I'll wear pants. And so in that sense, is if somebody does it a certain way, I think it's more important to be consistent than to be, you know, philosophically and religiously right. So I think I said this earlier, you know, do you know what's better than being right? Getting stuff done. And so, you know, to that, is there some level where I'll see it and I'm like, that's probably not how I would have done it, but we're not hurting anybody. Now we're going to decorate it. Select door, we'll go with users.
What are valid selectors?
What's that?
What can we put for selectors? Like, what are valid selectors there?
Whatever you want. Well, I don't know if you can actually overwrite like native HTML elements, or there are probably some reserved keywords you should not do.
You can use pseudo selectors, right? Like not a.
That's a good question. You know what? You just inherited a bonus challenge.
Yeah, you can use any valid CSS selector.
What?
Any valid CSS selector.
Wait, were you playing with me? Like, you knew the answer the whole time?
He was setting you up, yeah.
Yeah, that's... Scott. I see what you did there.
I was serving you. I was waiting for the spike.
Can't you see I'm under duress here? I'm live coding. Okay, so, class, import, decorator. Let's see if I can do something with this. Import users. If I get out of this alive, I will be so happy. Here we go, and this is actually important. Now that we want to use the users component within our home component, you need to define this as a directive dependency. So we'll just go users. If you do not do this, nothing will happen, and you will be left in a state of quandary, like, what's the deal? More often than not, it's because you forgot to add your dependency within your metadata. And so now that I have this, let's go over here. And oh yeah. What do you think, Scott? Do you think it's gonna work? Of course he does. He does have faith. We are the champions of the world. See this right here? Oh yeah. Let me just go back. I feel like I really didn't sell that appropriately. All right, everybody in the chat room, you might want to sit down for this. Oh, man, this is amazing. And then from there, we could enhance it.